Hey guys, this is GKCS. Today we'll be talking on BigIntegers, and it's a pretty interesting class in Java. I have seen people from other, you know, people using other programming languages come into Java because of this particular class. In comparative programming, there are questions in which you have these huge numbers and you need to perform operations like multiplication, addition, and stuff like that, you know, on them. And one of the simple ways to implement this is provided in Java through BigIntegers. So what we are going to do is we are going to discuss how we can construct BigIntegers, how we can perform operations on them, and also we are going to be solving a Codechef question using BigIntegers and try and get an AC for that. So firstly, let's try and construct a BigInteger. So these objects are rather easy to construct. In the constructor, you can pass in a string which contains your integer value, and that's what you'll have. Another way to do this is if you know you have a number which is not too big, then you can simply pass in the value as a long. So if it falls within the first 64 bits, within 64 bits, then yeah, you can pass this in. Another way to do this is if you have the simplest number. So of course this isn't a new way to do it. It's just that some constants like 0, 1, 2, they're already provided by BigInteger. So 2 isn't provided, actually it's 10. Now let's come to the basic operations of BigInteger. You can multiply a BigInteger with another BigInteger using the multiply operation. Now, what happens is if you try to print this number BigInteger, then that will print the object. And to keep things simple, let's bring this value down to, let's say, 55. So 22 into 55 is 1210. So we are expecting 1210. Let's see if we get that. Okay, we got a value of 22. Why did that happen? We just multiplied this BigInteger with 55 and still got a 22. The reason for this is, as it's suggested by IntelliJ, is that BigInteger.multiply is ignored. The result of BigInteger.multiply is ignored. Now, what we need to understand is that BigIntegers are immutable classes. When I say that a class or an object is immutable, it means that its internal state can never be changed. If this BigInteger has a value of 22, whatever operations you perform on it, its value, it will never change. So when I say multiply by 55, what's actually happening is a new object is being created in which 22 into 55 is being computed and inserted. So any kind of operations you can then, you know, add to this integer, let's say 13, you can then divide it. Of course, you need to add a BigInteger to this. So value 13, if you then feel like dividing it by value of 12, everything is fine. But the important thing is that, again, IntelliJ is suggesting it's ignored, because you actually haven't stored the result. This object is not being affected at all. So what we need to do is we actually need to take the result, divide, and let's name these things a little more cleanly. We have a B and we have C. And then we have the result. Now, if we print the result, we should get what we want. We should get 1210. In fact, we are going to get 1210 plus 13. 1223 divided by 12. So 101 should be the answer. That's what we are getting. So these are the kind of operations you can perform in BigInteger. A few interesting things, excuse me, are that you can you can do mod operations on BigInteger. So this does exactly what C mod K would do if you had a new BigInteger. Okay, that's these two operations are equivalent, except that you can do these on really big numbers using this class. The second interesting thing is that you can do mod inverse, which means you take this number and find the modulo inverse with another number. This is particularly useful in programming contests because often we are asked to find mod inverse, and I still don't know the algo to find out a mod inverse, but BigInteger saves me every time. The final thing that we need to look at before we jump into the problem is what does BigInteger offer in its multiplication operation. So when we go ahead and multiply, usually it's an n square operation. The high school math that we did, we took each digit and multiplied the other number by it, and then append zeros as we go ahead in the digit lineage. What BigInteger does is slightly smarter. It does the same thing up to a particular threshold, and then it starts using these interesting algos. So at best, BigInteger can change your n square algo to n raised to power 1.465. So there's a lot of documentation explaining when and why this is used, and you can go through it. But the interesting thing is BigInteger are pretty efficient in multiplications also. If you're looking for extremely efficient multiplication, then fast Fourier transform is the only way forward. But otherwise, these operations are pretty efficient by themselves. Okay, and one final thing is that BigInteger can also tell you whether a number is a probable prime. If you look at the kind of parameters that it needs a bit length and a random object. So what it says is that it returns a positive BigInteger that is probably prime with the specified bit length. The probability that a BigInteger returned is so you can go through this, but what it's actually doing is returning numbers which are probably prime by taking a, you can say, random function, and then also the size of the number. Not a random function, a random object. It uses this to actually create the number. Similar to that is BigInteger is probable prime, in which you can pass in certainty. Certainty is this is parameter which, as it increases, the probability that the number is prime is exponentially increasing. So is probable prime tells you if the number is probably prime, and the error rate reduces exponentially as you increase this value certainty. And again, as usual, we can read about the documentation over here. Right, so I think we are ready now to jump into the Codechef problem, which is FN control or something. Essentially, what it asks is make factorials of numbers and print them out. So that's exactly what we are going to be doing. We are going to be using this function, private BigInteger factorial, in which what you do is you pass in this integer n and you'll get n factorial. So let's just mention that returns, we have this cool thing. Yeah. Right. So how do we do this? We take this BigInteger, which will store our result, and we initialize it to value of 1. Now what we do is we set result to n factorial, and in a loop what we are doing is we are going on setting result to the multiplication of the next number with this result. Again, very important to know is that this is not correct. This is correct. You are assigning result to the new object which is being created. And finally, we can just return result. In our main program, what we need is we need a, you know, input reader. Buffered reader dot read line should give us our input, and then all we need to do is actually forgot to make it static. So all we need to do is pass in this number to the thing that we need, and let's just test this once. Let's pass in 5. We have 24. Now that's an issue. That's because I have a bug here, and now it should work. So it was less than. So I'm so accustomed to always writing less than that I now think of an equal to. 120 is the result. That is exactly what 5 factorial is. So what they're expecting is us to take a certain number of test cases along with n. So that's fine. We'll just take the test cases over here. And then for each test case, we're going to be taking n. Right, simple enough. Okay, we can actually pass this in directly. So I just inlined that, and we could in fact inline t2, but that, alright, that's useless. So let's just go back to that sample input that they have. Let's try and see if our program does exactly what they're asking. 4 test cases, 1, 2, 120, and 6. Yes, it seems like we have the solution. You can go ahead and write test cases, but let's submit this solution finally. Right, I'll remove the package name. Also, Codechef has this weird thing where you need to name your class main. Oh, God. Right, I better copy this, because I have to set my compiler to Java. Now that we are done with this, let's try and submit. This should work. If it doesn't, then it's BigInteger's fault. Come on. Please work. Correct solution. So that's pretty much it for BigInteger's. If you have any special requirements or any comments or queries or suggestions, anything, just put them in the comments below. I'll be you know, looking at all of them, and I'll be happy to help. And best of luck. Thanks. See you around.